Frankmoen AS is located in Bergen, Norway, and has a long tradition as the leading supplier of submerged cargo pumps to the world tanker market. The Framo Research and Development Department is working continuously, upgrading the pump design to meet all the latest international rules and regulations. Before you enter the cargo tank to service the cargo pump, always close the hydraulic pressure inlet valve and secure it. Purge the cofferdam and be familiar with the ship's safety rules. Also, pick up the number of standard tools you need for the service from the Framo toolbox. Before you start the service, study the cargo pump service manual carefully, description and drawings. We will now show you how to dismantle the new cargo pump SD200 design number 6. Sequence number 1. Dismantling of impeller and wear rings. Normal service done by the crew on board. Start by dismantling the pump support ring. The pump support ring is a new design, easy to clean and will also improve the stripping result. Lift and secure the support ring to the pipe stack. Use a rope for securing. Loosen the bolt for upper wear ring support. Then loosen the bolts on the impeller hub, two turns only. Turn the impeller clockwise for easier access and a better working condition for loosening the bolts. Press down the bolts and pump impeller. When the pump impeller is loose, remove the bolts. Then remove the bolts between the volute casing and cargo leg. Exchange two of the bolts with lowering lifting bolts. One bolt in each leg. Remove the rest of the bolts on the cargo flange and also between the volute casing and bearing housing. Finally, the volute casing, suction cover and pump impeller are now hanging by the lowering lifting bolts, diagonally positioned on each cargo leg. To avoid damage on the tank top, use plastic strips when sliding out the unit. Lower the whole unit down carefully, turning the lowering lifting bolts in parallel. Slide the unit out of the well. Remove the upper wear ring and inspect it carefully. Remove the seal element and the O-ring between impeller and impeller hub. These are usually parts which are fit for future use, but they have to be inspected and cleaned before assembly. The next step is to turn the unit upside down. The suction cover and the impeller can now be dismantled and the parts can be inspected. Pay special attention to the wear rings. Normal radial clearance when new is 0.3 millimeters. We recommend changing the wear rings if the radial clearance is more than 1 millimeter. loosen the locking bracket and remove the locking ring. Use the suction bell mouth to lift out the suction cover. And finally, lift up the pump impeller. Changing of wear rings is a service job normally done by the crew on board. How frequently depends primarily on the type of cargo. Check the impeller for any foreign particles which might be stuck inside. Some ships discharging cargo with a lot of sediment may have to do this job several times a year, while others carrying only clean oil products may run for 5 to 10 years before doing any service work on the cargo pump. Sequence number 2. Dismantling of double cargo lip seal and cofferdam seal. Normal service done by the crew on board. First, dismantle the cofferdam check pipe. Then dismantle the impeller hub from the pump shaft. Unscrew the lock nut and remove the nut and the lock washer. The impeller hub is pulled out by using an extractor from the Framo toolbox. Be very careful not to damage the O-rings and ceramic sleeve. Remove the ceramic sleeve retainer. Install the assembling cylinder to keep the ceramic sleeve in place and to protect the sensitive lips on the lip seals. Pull down the seal ring housing with the cargo seal. The Teflon seal element must be removed and controlled. Dismantle the double cargo seal. Inspect the parts and change if necessary. The Framo single cargo seal must also be dismantled. Changing of the cargo seals is also a normal service job on typical wear and tear parts, normally done by the crew on board. We recommend changing both the single and double cargo seals together. They're now delivered as one spare part, called the Framo seal set. For control or renewal of the ceramic sleeve, the assembling cylinder has to be removed. The ceramic sleeve must be handled very carefully, as it's brittle and may crack if dropped or mishandled. Sequence number 3. Draining of pump. Heavy maintenance. If you ever have to renew the mechanical oil seal, follow this procedure. Check that the hydraulic pressure inlet valve and the valve on the pilot line are closed and secured. Open the local control valve. Release all pressure chambers by using the bleed plugs in the STC valve and non-return valve. Remove the blind flange at the drain connection located under the pump cover. Use the drain tool to unscrew the plug. Connect the hose with a snap-on coupling in the air-operated pump delivered by Framo to the female snap-on coupling. Pump the oil into a drum placed on deck. Remember, the oil is not to be refilled. Sequence number 4. Dismantling of mechanical oil seal or other remaining rotating parts in the cargo pump. Heavy maintenance. When the mechanical oil seal is to be removed, the pump unit must be disconnected from the pipe stack. Change two of the bolts with lowering lifting bolts, diagonally positioned. Remove the rest of the bolts. Lower the unit down carefully by turning the lowering bolts in parallel. Remove the seal elements between the pump and pipe stack. Install the bracket on the flange on top of the pump cover and turn the whole unit upside down. Remove the bolts between the flange for bearing housing and the pump cover. Install the support bolts through the clearance hole in the flange for the bearing housing and into the holes in the pump cover. Install the plate and secure to the support bolts by nuts. Install the lifting bolts through holes in the plate and into the hole in the flange for bearing housing. Turning the lifting nuts can now lift the motor and bearing housing assembly. Check that the lifting bolts do not work loose from the flange for the bearing housing. Remove 4 of 8 bolts between the bearing housing and the flange for the bearing housing. Lift up the seal rings to the flange for the bearing housing. Place support brackets in the correct position. Secure to the pump cover by 4 bolts. Lower the bearing bracket onto the support bracket. Remove the plate, lifting bolts and support bolts. Remove the remaining 4 bolts between the bearing housing and flange for bearing housing and remove the upper seal house. Remove the flange for the bearing housing and dismantle the stationary part of the mechanical oil seal. The lapped faces of the ceramic seal must be treated very carefully. The stationary part is very brittle and may crack if dropped or scratched against other parts. Before removing the rotating part of the mechanical seal, loosen the 3 locking screws. Use a special tool to remove the rotating part of the mechanical seal. Be sure that locking screws are not in contact with the shaft when the rotating part of the mechanical seal is pulled out. All parts must be cleaned thoroughly and inspected. If it becomes necessary sometime in the future to dismantle the pump shaft, ball bearings and backstop unit, this can easily be done by following the instructions in the service manual. The same applies to the hydraulic motor. Remember to check that the shaft seal is removed before a new hydraulic motor is installed. Sequence number 5. Assembling sequence. Use Loctite on the set screws before assembly of the rotating part of the mechanical seal. Be careful when installing the stationary part of the mechanical seal. Remember not to use grease on the O-ring. Use soapy water. On this pump design, please pay special attention to the cargo seal. The double cargo lip seal must be installed correctly. The spring marked red on the double lip seal should be mounted against the cofferdam. Make sure that the support ring is tightened up to metal contact to avoid screws loosening. Check all seal elements, seal grooves and seal faces carefully. Pay special attention to the Teflon rings and be absolutely sure of no deformation. Never install a damaged O-ring and be sure to check for corrosion, cracks, dirt, etc. And remember, use only genuine spare parts. If any abnormal lifetime on the cargo seal has been experienced, check the runout on the ceramic sleeve after assembly of the impeller flange. All screws and nuts have to be assembled with specified torque. Use new locking plates to secure the bolts for the upper and lower wearing support. Sequence number 6. Pressure testing. Test running. After assembly, visually check the cargo pump and the cargo tank. No rags or other components must be left in the cargo tank. Pressure test the cargo pump's cofferdam with 3 bar pressure. The cofferdam must be pressure tested by blinding off the cofferdam vent pipe. Unscrew the complete air relief valve and connect a pressure gauge to the connection. Connect the air nitrogen connection on the top cover plate. Increase the pressure to max 3 bar and control that the pressure is stable for approximately 30 minutes. Test run the cargo pump, purge the cofferdam and check that everything is okay. If the hydraulic oil in the cargo pump has been drained during the service, remove air from the pump stack through the air venting plug on deck before test running. By following these instructions, you will achieve a long-lasting, well-functioning cargo pumping system.